Hi, and welcome to Ivy League Analytical English. I'm Angela.
And I'm Wesley.
Today is July 21st. We're on page 58 of the magazine. We're doing an article by our good friend Bruce about two influential literature contests from the United Kingdom.
Yep, 我中文标题是不可错过的文学奖巨擘，布克奖与非布克奖。
So, I mean, the Chinese title kind of spills the story already, but
yeah.
What I like, it's fun because it's a two-day article and it's a great way to do this particular, it's a great structure to tell this particular story because yesterday we talked about the Booker Prize and today we're going to talk about the not the Booker Prize. And I love this title, Not the Booker Prize, because it's kind of a really sarcastic way to do things in English. When you're titling something that it's not the other one, you're automatically making everyone laugh.
好，所以这个今天我们要谈的是 Not the Booker Prize. 昨天我们谈的是 The Booker Prize. 那今天我们要谈的是 Not the Booker Prize. 这在英文里面是很长很有趣的一种这个文字游戏。 你在这个前面加一个 not， 一方面就是在调侃另外一个这个奖， 一方面 又好像在同时在这个告诉人家说这个奖到底是毕竟还蛮重要的，所以我们才会要not这个奖。
In Chinese, when you say like 非不可奖, like is it the same level of funny as it's saying not the Booker Prize in English?
Maybe half.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'm always interested in how much humor translates when it goes to another language.
Oh, usually a lot of humor is lost.
Yeah, usually. Yeah. So I was wondering, did it translate in this case? Did it get lost in translation or did it pull through? Did it come through the translation?
Yeah, maybe I would say 50% to 70%.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Because it's just too funny, not the Booker Prize. And then it works kind of, you know, 非不可奖。
Yeah.
So the coolest thing, or the interesting thing about the Booker Prize is that it was really the British person's prize. They let everybody in the whole English-speaking world of British origin to attend. They let everybody do the Booker Prize except Americans, which is kind of funny. It's like a funny exclusion. But recently, all those poor Americans could finally get in on that Booker Prize action and that sweet Booker Prize action. And they said anybody writing in English. So it doesn't matter where you're from. If you wrote it in English, it can now be considered for the Booker Prize. So you don't have to even be American. You could be writing in your second language and you're eligible.
Yeah. 所以这个布克奖呢，本来仅限于英国，还有或者是大英国协等等少数几个国家的人能够参加。但是呢，后来它已经扩大了，只要你是用英文写作，都可以参加。So
if one of our listeners wrote a novel in English, they could also be considered for the Booker Prize if it was good.
Yeah, 所以这个我们的这个听众之间，如果有人用英文写了一本小说，只要写得够好，这个也可以参加这个布克奖的角逐。
Okay, so let's read about the not the Booker Prize. The Booker Prize has spawned a sort of good-natured copycat award from the famed British newspaper The Guardian called Not the Booker Prize. The publication organizes a competition whose winner is determined by the newspaper's readers. Based on book reviews submitted by readers, a panel of judges from The Guardian determines which five books will be considered finalists for the Not the Booker Prize, according to how convincing and well thought out the reviews were. A sixth book is added by the previous year's panel of judges. These six books are referred to as the shortlist. The newspaper's readers are then invited to vote, one vote per reader, for the shortlisted book they consider the finest piece of fiction writing of the previous year. They do not simply name their favorite candidate. Every vote must also include a 100-word critique of their favorite novel. Representatives from The Guardian select three readers who had submitted reviews to form a panel of judges. A final judging round is then arranged to choose the winning book. For 2017, the book chosen was Dark Chapter, by none other than Taiwanese writer Winnie M. Lee. The book examines a sexual assault, a topic of great current interest around the world. The Taiwanese protagonist, Vivian, endures a horrific and lasting trauma from a teenage Irishman. Judges felt Lee's depiction of the aftermath of not only the abused woman's experience, but also that of her attacker, was profoundly realistic and moving. One judge noted that Lee's novel stayed with her longer than any other among the excellent works of fiction. We have much to look forward to, as Dark Chapter is Lee's first novel. Well, I'm going to say that the Not a Booker Prize is seemingly very complicated, but that's only because the mechanics of how it works is very public, whereas we don't really know how the Booker Prize's mechanics work, and it might be just as convoluted. But what I like about the Not a Booker Prize's mechanics is that they are so designed to, first of all, invite the participation of, like, the most possible people.
Yeah.
And second of all, to encourage people to write and express their opinions.
Mm-hmm.
So that in the process, you get to learn about many more books than you would have otherwise normally come across in your daily life.
对这个 Not the Booker Prize 它有些地方显然我觉得相当的不错，很好，它这个让更多的人参与，尤其是你要投票的话，你还要写一个这个 review 那所以换句话说，它不但是参与投票，这些人也事实上也在参与创作，所以这个在这方面来看。 这个 Not the Booker Prize 也是非常的好。
It's just really interesting.
Yeah.
And also I like reading it because you get to read about a lot of interesting books.
Yeah. 所以你这个其实你如果参与的话，你也可以读很多，读到很多关于不同的书，或者甚至于不同书的这个内容都可以。
So the Booker Prize, we're at the beginning of the article now. The Booker Prize has spawned a sort of good-natured copycat award. If something has spawned something, it's different than giving birth to something. When you spawn something, when a fish spawns their young, they drop off a bunch of eggs. The female drops off a bunch of eggs, and then the male comes along and fertilizes it. It's a very external process. Whereas giving birth is like the end result, and you end up having this live baby. So like, I feel like giving birth as a metaphor is much more personal. And spawning is much more impersonal as a metaphor for creating something from something else. So they...
So spawn这个字呢, 这个刚刚Angela讲有一点跟 giving birth有一点差别, 它是比较外在的受孕的一种方式,就鱼下卵啊, 然后这个公鱼再来让这些卵受精, 所以比较不是那么personal, 但是to give birth感觉起来就是比较personal那种感觉。 那同时呢, spawn这个字呢, 它常常是有比较这个负面的意思，有那种 derogatory 那种感觉。Oh
yeah, that's true.
Yeah, 它跟这个 produce 这个或者是跟这个 give birth to.
Maybe it's because we think of fish as lower order animals.
Maybe, yeah. 也许因为我们认为鱼是比较低等的这个生物，所以 spawn 这个字有这种 association 就是它常常是比较负面的一种生产的意思。
So it's an interesting choice, actually, in terms of like that it indicates a certain attitude. So the Booker Prize has spawned a sort of good-natured copycat award. Good-natured means it's meant well. Mm-hmm. It's not like meant to hurt people. It's like, oh, yeah, it's for fun. Copycat means they're doing the same thing. And it's from the famed British newspaper, The Guardian, which is one of my favorite newspapers. I think it's my most favorite newspaper in the world. I just like The Guardian a lot. Anyways, this newspaper is called, this prize is called the Not the Booker Prize, which I love to death.
Yeah. 好，所以呢，这地方看到他说这个 the Booker Prize 啊 ，the Booker Prize 是它有生产出来或者是它促成了一个怎么样 good natured 一个善意的 copycat 就是一种模仿的行为，但在这里它是用来修饰那个 award， 所以它。 促成的另外一个文学奖，它是模仿这个布克奖，但是它是善意的模仿，那这个是来自于哪里的一个文学奖呢？是这个 famed 就是 renowned 就是知名的英国报纸，The Guardian 这个报纸，那这个奖 called 被称为这个 Not the Booker Prize。
I think the reason I like The Guardian is that they take their work seriously, but they don't take themselves seriously. So. You know what I mean? So they do good quality work, but they're not like, oh, we are the best or whatever, you know? They just simply are the best without talking about it.
Wow. 好，所以The Guardian, 他们这个新闻的品质很好，但他们不会把自己看的是这个顶尖的新闻从业者，所以这一点是Angela老师特别喜欢他们的地方。
So my opinions aside, the publication organizes a competition every year whose winner is determined by the newspaper's readers, which is a fairly common format in the world that newspaper readers will pick a winner of something.
好，the publication 就是指这个 The Guardian 啊，他们 organizes 他们筹划了一个 competition 一个竞赛。好，那这个竞赛的得奖者呢 is determined by determine 就是 这个决定啊，它通常的 firmly decide 的意思啊，比较正式的感觉啊，由谁决定呢？由这个报纸的读者来决定。
But the way that they do it is kind of interesting. Based on book reviews submitted by readers, a panel of judges from the Guardians determines which five books will be considered finalists for the Not the Booker Prize, according to how convincing and well thought out the reviews were. So what they're doing is they're not judging the books, they're judging how passionately the person promoting the book, how well they wrote, how convincing they were. It's basically judging persuasive writing.
Yeah.
If you can make me really want to read this book, then okay, I'll choose your book. It's not really about the books themselves.
Yeah, 所以很有趣，他比较不是说直接拿几本书啊，大家评审来读一读之后来选哪一本比较好，而是他是以这个 book reviews 为主啊，这个书评为主。所以这里讲到说 based on 他是以什么，以 book reviews 书评啊。那这书评怎么样？是 submitted by readers， 是由读者所提交的书评啊。那 submit 这个字呢，通常就是 to present something to a person 或者是 to a body 啊，一个团体，通常是重点是 for consideration 啊，或者是这个 for judgment 啊，就让对方来评断的意思。所以是由读者提交的书评啊，他们根据这些来做决定。那根据这些读者提交的书评呢 ，a panel of judges 也是一样，有个评审团啊，从这个 The Guardian 啊来的，来自于 The Guardian 的评审团呢，他们会 determines， 他们会决定 which five books 哪五本书啊 will be considered 会被认为是 finalists， 这就是决赛的入围者啊。那 for the not the Booker Prize， 那他到底怎么样这个决定谁要入围呢？他根据的是。According to how convincing 啊，这个如何的具有说服力啊，是否具有说服力？还有 well thought out， well thought out 中文可以说是周延的程度。那 well thought out 本身的意思是 carefully considered 啊 and planned， 所以就是你这些 review 啊，这些 review 写的时候呢，有没有说服力？然后呢，这个 review 周延程度啊，这写的够不够周延？根据这些，他们决定最后的决赛成入围者。
So they're basically judging the reviews as a piece of writing.
Yeah, 所以他们基本上他们评论的是这些书评，然后看他们写的怎么样，写的有没有说服力，写的够不够周延。
A sixth book is added by the previous year's panel of judges. So five books are chosen by the readers, and a sixth book is chosen by the judges from the previous year.
然后他说，刚选了五本书了嘛，那第六本书呢 is added 被加进来，是由怎么样？前一年的这个评审团啊，因为他评审团的成员每年会不固定，所以前一年的评审团他们可以推荐第六本书啊，这样子就总共有六本了。
These six books are referred to as the shortlist. Now this term, the shortlist, isn't just only used by the Not the Booker Prize thing. Just about any contest, especially not contest, but any sort of judging.Situation, they often have what's called a shortlist because judging is so hard. You have to first narrow it down to a group and then decide which one of the group is the best one. And so that group that is narrowed down to is often called the shortlist.
Mm-hmm. So the shortlist, the shortlist 通常就指的是这个决选名单的意思啊。那这个字有时候你会看到它有时候有当动词啊，像有的书封面上面讲。Shortlisted for 什么什么什么奖
？Yes，
呀， yeah, 那就是表示啊，他已经进入了这个奖的决选名单。那通常呢，进入决选名单就表示相当不错了。就好像这个什么奥斯卡奖啊、金马奖啊、各种影展，你只要能够入围，就表示肯定了。
For Oscars, though, we talk about being nominated for it rather than being shortlisted for it.
Oh, yeah.
For some reason, the language of movies is nominated, and the language of books is shortlisted.Nobel Prize winners are shortlisted rather than nominated.
Yeah.
But I think it's just a habit thing as opposed to a hard, fast rule.
Yeah, 那所以不过习惯上面电影的这个入这通常中文也是这样，中文我们讲电影叫做入围啊，那所以这个电影的语言会不太一样，不过它基本的概念是差不多的啊。好，那我们所以这个地方讲到说这六本书呢就被称为是这个决选名单里面的这个六本书。
So then, the newspaper's readers are then invited to vote, one vote per reader, I wonder how they do that, for the shortlisted book they consider the finest piece of fiction writing of the previous year. So the readers are probably judging the books again and not judging on the reviews. Or they might be, you know, because you get a chance to read the reviews, so you're definitely persuaded as well by the persuasive piece of writing.
Yeah.
But yeah, but mm-hmm. I think the readers are also picking based on the book that they like.
Yeah, 所以读者也许也是靠 review, 或者是当然也有可能是靠他读过那本书。那而且最重要的是我们会看到这些读者他们也要写书评。所以我们看到他说这个地方啊，他说、嗯、yeah, 所以这个报纸的读者呢接下来就被邀请来投票。那一个人只能投一次票。所以很显然他一个人只能投一次票，大概就看你写了几篇嘛。我想大概也没有人会一个人写了很多篇。
No, I figured it out. This is why they know that there's only one vote per reader. Because mm-hmm. you have to write 100-word critique.
Yeah.
And then you have to append your name to it.
Yeah,
and once
exactly.
they've accepted one critique, they're not going to accept another one. Well, you could write it under a pen
yeah,
name,
that's what I was saying, yeah.
Oh, I missed
yeah,
that.
I can write 100 reviews.
Under 100 different pen names.
Yeah.
But don't you think after a while they're going to be like, I recognize this style, that's that Wesley dude again.
Yeah, yeah. Very likely, huh?
But
so, yeah.
Have you ever voted in this?
No. 所以这个很有趣哈，这个所以他请一个人只能投一次票啊，那就只有在这个入围的，就最后这个进入决选名单的这些书，你可以跟在这些书里面投票啊，投什么呢 ？What they consider the finest piece of fiction writing 啊，他们觉得是这个最棒的小说的写作啊 ，of the previous year， 因为他们选的都前一年出来的小说嘛。
So, like we were just talking about, they, meaning the voters, do not simply name their favorite candidate. They don't just go.You know, that author.
嗯，好，那这些读者呢，他们不是就 simply, 他们不是那么单纯就把他们最喜欢的这个候选人的名字把它写出来，把它提名出来，不是这样子。
Every vote must also include a 100-word critique of their favorite novel. So they've got to write a little essay.
Yeah, yeah. That's what I like about this. You know, you have to write to vote.
Right.
So
it's really encouraging literature in its best way.
Exactly.
Yeah.
所以他每一个人你要投票呢，你也要包含一个100字的 critique， 就是这个批评啊，就是或者评论他们最喜欢的小说啊。那一百字啊，其实一百字要写好很不容易。
Also, well, yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Mm-hmm. But also, they publish excerpts of these.In the final thing, like they pick their favorite lines out and tell you, and that's fun too.
Oh, they do that?
Yeah, in the final article about all of this.
Oh.
They point out some of the reviews that they liked that are not the main reviews.
Oh, so they 在最后这个在公布得奖的东西这个名单的时候，他们也会把一些读者写的一些很精彩的这个 review， 他们也会弄进去。
And the winning one is published there. So if you win, you also get your words published in the newspaper, which is kind of a thrill if you're not normally used to.
哦，那你如果这个写得好的话，这个是得奖的这些小说里面你写的这个 review 很好的话，那报纸也会登出来，所以你也是被 published。
Yeah, I mean, if you're interested, you can Google, I'm talking to our readers now, our listeners, you can Google, you can look up on the internet, to be a little more, less partisan about it.
Mm-hmm.
You just look up the Not the Booker Prize previous mm-hmm. articles, and you get sort of an understanding of the final article they write about all this.
Oh.
And it's fun to read.
Yeah, 你可以有兴趣，各位可以去网络上面啊，这个只要去这个搜寻一下，就可以看到之前啊，他们这些人这个得奖的作品，还有这些 review， 他们怎么写
？Representatives from the Guardian select 3 readers who had submitted reviews to form a panel of judges. So even the judges are readers, which is I hadn't actually realized up until now.
Yeah， 好，所以这个他说从 The Guardian 的这个代表呢，从那里来的代表，他们选三位读者啊，那他们当然也都是要有交这个 review 的读者啊，他们最后会形成一个这个评审团。
This is really by the people, for the people, of the people kind
of
stuff, you know,
like... 非常民主的一个奖, yeah.
Mm, so, a final judging round is then arranged to choose the winning book, and for 2017, the book chosen was Dark Chapter, by none other than Taiwanese writer Winnie M. Lee. How cool is that?
Yeah, 好,那这个地方,他说 a final, 最后的一个 judging round, 一个评审的 round 可以说是回合,最后一回合的评审。就被安排 arranged 来选出这个得奖的作品。那在2017年啊获选的这本书呢 ,The Book Chosen 啊是这个Dark Chapter 啊这个叫做生命暗章。 那 by none other than, 当你英文看到这个 by none other than, 好，它就一中文就是不是别人，正是谁那种语气，好，所以你不要想说是谁，就是这一个，没错啊，是谁呢？是一个台湾啊，这应该是台裔的一个作家啊，这个 Winnie M. Lee.
And so our final paragraph describes the book that Winnie M. Lee wrote, and it's not that easy, actually. It's not a comfortable book to read, I imagine. The book examines a sexual assault. Just right there, you know it's not going to be an easy read. And sexual assault, of course, is a topic of great current interest around the world, what with Me Too trending in 2017.
Yeah.
And the kind of great wave of male accountability that's happening, and long may it continue.
好，所以呢，这本书呢，它检视啊 examines 一个 sexual assault 一个性侵的案例，这个 topic 同伟哥告诉你 ，this is a topic of great current interest， 就是当前大家正这个都感到很有兴趣的一个话题。Current 就是当前的意思啊，那这个其中这个2017年年底哈、啊，一直就持续到今年哈、啊，就是大家对于这种就男性不可以这个骚扰或者性骚扰或者这当然更不能性侵女性啊，那这些。话题是大家都感到非常全世界 around the world 都现在都非常关切这个话题。
So the Taiwanese protagonist is the main character in the book, who is Taiwanese, and her name is Vivian. She endures a horrific and lasting trauma. So horrific means it's bad. Lasting means it sticks around. Trauma from a teenage Irishman, who is our villain probably.
Yeah, 好，那这个台湾这个台湾的这个台裔的主人翁好叫 Vivian, 啊他 endures, 他忍受一个好这个 horrific, 就是在这里就是 causing horror, 啊或者是这个 shock, 啊很恐怖的然后而且是 lasting, 啊这持续很久的啊那我们上英文常讲 a lasting effect, 就是持续很久的效果影响啊那所以他有一个很恐怖又持续很久的一个 trauma, 一个创伤啊是来自于这创伤是来自于一个爱尔兰的这个青少年。
Judges felt Lee's depiction of the aftermath of not only the abused woman's experience, but also that of her attacker. They felt that both of the depictions of these two people's stories was profoundly realistic and moving. If something is moving, it means it affects you emotionally.
好，所以凭什么认为这个李怀瑜他的 depiction, 他的描述什么呢？The aftermath 就是后续的这个影响啊，什么影响呢？不只是这一个 abused woman's experience 啊，就这一个被侵害的这个女性啊，她的经验啊的后续影响，而且呢，还包括她的攻击她的那个人啊，她自己内心的一些后续的影响。那关于这些的描述呢，评审认为是非常的 profoundly realistic 啊 ，profoundly 就很深刻的 realistic 真写实，非常深刻的写实。而且最重要大概是感人 moving.
One judge noted that Lee's novel stayed with her longer than any other among the excellent works of fiction. So if something stays with you, it means that you keep thinking about it.
好，所以这个有一个评审呢 noted, 好，他指出啊，他的这个李怀瑜这本小说呢 stayed with her longer, 就是一直让他不断去想，让他的这个持续的影响他，让他不断去思考。好，那这个不断的感受到这个小说比其他的这个 excellent works of fiction 都还要来得久啊，所以换句话说，这个小说对他来讲就非常的深刻，非常的感动他。
We have much to look forward to as Dark Chapter is Lee's first novel, and what this sentence implies is that we're expecting more great things from Winnie M. Lee.
Yeah, 那 we have much to look forward to, 就是我们有很多可以期待啊，因为呢。这个小说只是这个李怀瑜的第一本小说，所以显然他接下来他应该还能够继续创作，而且会有很多很好的作品出来。
We have some questions here for you, of course, about both days of the article. Number one of which is, which of the following literary awards is not mentioned in the article?
本文没有提到底下哪一项文学奖。
And that would be A, the British Book Awards, poor things.
那样应该是答案是 A, 英国国家书奖，这个没有提到。
And number two, according to the article, which of the following statements is accurate?
根据本文，下列哪一项叙述是真的？
The answer is B, the current prize for winning the Man Booker Prize for Fiction is £50,000. They could be yours for writing a prize-winning novel.
好，那答案是 B, 这是正确的。就曼布克奖目前的优胜奖金是50,000英镑。
And number three, which of the following concerning the Not the Booker Prize is discussed in the article?
本文探讨了下面哪一项有关非布克奖的叙述。
The answer is D, how the shortlist is selected.
答案是 D, 好，我们有谈到他们是如何选出决赛的名单。
And number four, according to the article, which of the following statements about Dark Chapter is true?
好，根据本文，下列有关生命暗章的叙述何者为真？
The answer is C. It was the first published effort by the author. It was her first book.
这答案是 C. 它是作者的第一部出版作品。
Well, that's all we have for you today, but it was a lot. It was a lot of fun talking about both these prizes. We look forward to seeing you again the next time for more Ivy League Analytical English. Until then, bye-bye. Bye.